Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693CPU313. This is described as a 5-slot rack with embedded CPU. So it's a CPU slot rack. And it's being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply. And I've got it connected to Proficy Machine Edition. So our goal here is to try and get the processor into run mode and have it remain in run mode. So this is a test just to see the functionality and make sure that the processor is in good working order. So the first thing I want to point out is if you think it's a troubled CPU and you remove any modules and you have it on its own the way that you see that I have it here with a power supply, if you turn the power supply on and you have an okay light, that's a good start. And however, if you don't have an OK light, if this green LED next to OK is not on, then immediately you have a problem with the processor, and it's done a self-diagnostic, there is a problem, and you won't be able to follow this test. So hopefully you have the OK light on and it's powered up. Now in Proficy Machine Edition, what I've done is I've selected a brand new file, a clean open file, and I've selected under CPU. If you open up your navigator under main rack, you can right click on CPU or double click on CPU, and that allows you to change the module of the type of CPU. And I've chosen a CPU 313 and I've chosen a PWR 330 just as you physically see it in front of you. There are no other modules just because this is a test to make sure that the functionality of the CPU is on its own is working and able to get into run mode. So now that I do have it powered up and I'm in Proficy Machine Edition, the first thing I want to do is click on the lightning bolt icon, which is the online offline button to get connected to the processor. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, and then once I've got that on, a green handprint icon, which is toggle to online mode or program mode, I'm going to click that. All right. Now that I'm in program mode, on my top menu bar under target, open that up, click on online commands, go to clear, and you want to clear controller fault table and IO fault table only. I would not do all memory and I wouldn't do anything that would erase anything that you may need. So once you've selected the bottom two selections again, that's controller fault table and IO fault table, go ahead and select OK. And then click yes to clear those. And once that's cleared, I'm going to hit the download and start active target button. So it's the icon to the far right that shows downloading information and a play button or a run button. I'm going to click that. Now the first window that's going to pop open is going to ask you what exactly do you want to download to the controller. Just configuration and logic. So you don't want to set any I/O in motion or attempt to download any I/O, and you don't want to put anything to permanent flash memory. Again, this is just a test to turn the CPU to run mode and have it remain there. So I'm going to select OK to configuration and logic. And it's going to tell you that there's a build in progress. A window will pop open asking if you want to overwrite this as a new name. You want to select yes. And then the last frame that will pop open is going to ask you if you want to turn the outputs on, the I/O on, or put the controller into run mode. Outputs enabled, yes. Start controller. All right, now we're in run mode. I've got this green LED, so if you've gotten that far and you select run mode, you should get this green LED to come on once you start the controller. If that doesn't come on, then you need to read through your feedback zone, which is in the bottom left-hand corner, and find out why it's not in run mode. You could have selected the wrong CPU, or there could be a problem with the CPU. So my goal here would be, if this is a processor I think is a problem with, what I want to do is leave this in run mode for a couple days, 2 or 3 days, just to see that it doesn't kick itself out of run mode for some reason. If you come back after 2 or 3 days and it's still in run mode, it's likely a healthy processor. There's probably nothing wrong with it. If you come back and it's not in run mode and it's evident that it kicked itself out, what you want to do is go into Proficy Machine Edition once again to target. And then 3/4 of the way down, you'll see Diagnostics. And you click on that, and in your Info Viewer tab, the main screen, a fault table viewer will pop open, and it'll give you the location and the description of the problem, the fault or error. And it's something, sometimes it's technical information that's difficult to understand without a manual. Sometimes it's could be pretty obvious what the description is. It's different every time. But if you go through this process and you feel that there's truly a problem with your processor, if it is broken or if it's not able to function the way that I described that we test these products, then it's something that is likely broken, and we can repair these. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that is something that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.